Hello all, welcome to this video on microprocessors and microcontrollers. Today we'll be solving a problem on memory interfacing, which is about static RAM and ROM interfacing with 8086 or 8088. Before solving the problem, let's see a bit on static RAM interfacing. Semiconductor RAMs are broadly classified into two types, static RAM and dynamic RAM. Semiconductor memories are organized as two-dimensional arrays of memory locations. For example, 4K into 8 or 4K byte memory contains 4096 locations, where each location contains 8-bit data, and only one of these 4096 locations can be selected at a time. Once a location is selected, all the bits in it are accessible using a group of conductors called data bus. Obviously, for addressing 4K bytes of memory, 12 address lines are required. In general, to address a memory location out of capital N memory locations, we'll require at least small n bits of address or small n address lines, where small n is equal to log of capital N to the base 2. Thus, if the microprocessor has small n address lines, then it is able to address at the most capital N locations of memory, where 2 raised to small n is equal to capital N. However, if out of the capital N locations, only capital P memory locations need to be interfaced, then the least significant small p address lines out of the available small n lines can be directly connected from the microprocessor to the memory chip, while the remaining small n minus small p higher order address lines may be used for address decoding, that is as inputs to the chip selection logic. Also, the memory address depends upon the hardware circuit used for decoding the chip select. The output of the decoding circuit is connected with the CS pin of the memory chip. Now let us see the general procedure for static memory interfacing with 8086. First, we arrange all the available memory chips in such a way to obtain a 16-bit data bus width. The upper 8-bit bank is called the odd address memory bank, and the lower 8-bit bank is called the even address memory bank. Then we connect the available memory address lines of the memory chip with those of the microprocessor, and also the memory read and write pins to the corresponding processor control signals. Also connect the 16-bit data bus of the memory bank with that of the microprocessor. At last, we take all the remaining address lines of the microprocessor, BHE and A0, for decoding the required chip select signal for odd and even memory banks. The CS of memory is derived from the output of the decoding circuit. As a good and efficient interfacing practice, the address map of the system should be continuous as far as possible. That is, there should be no windows in the map and no foldback space should be allowed. A memory location should have a single address corresponding to it. That is, absolute decoding should be preferred, and minimum hardware should be used for decoding. In a number of cases, linear decoding may be used to minimize the required hardware. Let's move on to the problem. Interface two 4K into 8 EPROMs and two 4K into 8 RAM chips with 8086 using a suitable memory map. As we already know, after a reset, the instruction pointer and the code segment register will be initialized to form the address FFF0H. This address must lie in the EPROM. However, the address for RAM may be selected anywhere in the 1 MB address space of 8086, but here we should select it in such a way that the memory map is continuous. Also remember that EPROM is program memory and RAM is data memory. 1K is 1024 bytes, which can be written as 2 raised to 10. In the question, it is given as 2 4K into 8 EPROMs and 2 4K into 8 RAM chips. So 2 4K is 8K 8K can be written as 2 raised to 13, which means that we'll need 13 address lines for addressing this memory. This A0 to A12 can be selected for that. Now we need to obtain the address range. 1024 is 00400H in hex. So the range for 1K can be obtained as 00000H, that's the starting address, to 00300FH. This ending address was obtained by subtracting 1 from the size of 1K in hex. That is 00400H minus 1H gives this answer. Similarly, for 2K, it is 1K plus 1K. Adding this displacement twice will give me 00700FH. This is the range for 2K. So 4K will be 2K plus 2K. The displacement is 00700FH. It will be added twice to get 00FFH. This is the range for 4K. In our question, we have 8K. So 8K can be written as 4K plus 4K. Adding this twice will give me this range. As we saw in the previous slide, EEPROM is somewhere near this address, so towards the end of the 1MB. So what we are going to do is, we'll take the last address of 1MB, that is FFFFH, and subtract 8K from it in order to obtain the starting address of this 8K EEPROM segment, that is FE000H to FFFFH will be the range for 8K of memory of EEPROM. Similarly, for RAM, we need to choose an address space that is continuous with this. So what we do here is we subtract 1 from the starting address of EEPROM, that is FD-FFH, and we subtract 8K from it in order to obtain the starting address of RAM. So that is FC-000H to FD-FFH will give you 8K of RAM. And this is how it can be shown in the 1MB space. This is for EEPROM and this is for RAM, the starting and ending address of both of them. Since 8086 has 20 address lines in the memory map, we'll show the address lines from A0 to A19. Now, we'll first of all draw the memory map for EEPROM. As we have derived in this slide, we know the starting and ending address of EEPROM 8K segment. So we'll begin with the last, that is ending address, FFFFH. We'll map it till the starting address FE000H and we'll write the corresponding binary and fill in the address line values. We are only writing the starting and the ending addresses. The addresses in bitwin are not written. If we write it, the map will be much larger. We'll give the specification, that is EEPROM 8K into 8. Similarly, for RAM, it's FC-000H to FD-FFH. We write the ending address first, then the starting address, and we fill in the corresponding address lines with the binary values. And we give the specification of RAM as this. Since both of them have 8K memory space, 8K can be written as 2 raised to 13. So after A12, we'll draw a dotted line to show that the address lines from A0 to A12 will be the ones that is directly connected to the processor, and the rest, A13 to A19, will be used for decoding the chip select signal. When we examine this memory map, we'll see that in case of A13 address line, its value is 1 for EEPROM and 0 for RAM. Thus, we can use this line to distinguish between EEPROM and RAM. Since this is an 8086 problem, we'll have odd address bank and even address bank. To choose that, we'll have two lines, A0 and BHE. We already know that when A0 is 0 and BHE is 1, it means the even bank is selected. And whenever A0 is 1 and BHE is 0, the odd bank is selected. And when both of them are 0, then the transfer is a 16-bit word transfer. And if both of them are 1, then no data will be selected. Now we'll draw a truth table using BHE, A0 and A13, because A13 is the one distinguishing EEPROM and RAM. Since we have 3 lines for the decoder, 3 input lines, we'll choose a 3:8 decoder. And the decoder inputs A0, A1, A2 will be BHE, A0 and A13 respectively. Here we have derived all the possible combinations except the one for which A0 and BHE are 1, because in that case no data will be selected. So we'll have 6 combinations here. When we draw the circuit, we draw it in such a way that the two 4K x 8 chips of RAM and ROM are arranged in parallel to obtain a 16-bit data bus width. When A0 is 0, that is the address is even. And when it is in RAM, then the lower RAM chip is selected, indicating an 8-bit transfer at an even address. When A0 is 1, that is, then the address is odd, and if it is in RAM, then BHE will go low and the upper RAM chip is selected, further indicating an 8-bit transfer at odd address. If the selected addresses are in ROM, then the respective ROM chips are selected. If at a time both A0 and BHE are 0, both the RAM or ROM chips are selected. That is, the data transfer is of 16 bits. Now we'll draw the circuit. We have already said that we need a 3:8 decoder, that it is a 74138 decoder. We have the three inputs A0, A1 and A2 as BHE, A0 and A13. And we'll have 8 outputs, that is O0 to O7. We'll name it as 0, 1, 2, 3 till 7. This decoder has 3 enable lines, E1, E2 and E3. Here E1 and E2 are active low signals, whereas E3 is active high. Since these two are active low, their inputs will be inverted. And from the address map, we derived that lines from A13 to A19 was reserved for decoding the chip select, but A13 is taken as an input to the decoder. So the remaining A14 to A19 will be given as the input of a NAND gate 7430 and fed into the enable pins. When it is given to E3, which is an active high pin, we'll pass it through a NOT gate so that all the three will be active at the same time. Now we'll arrange the ROM and RAM chips, both the ROM chips in parallel and both the RAM chips in parallel, so as to get the 16-bit data bus width. Also, we give a chip select to all the chips CS1, CS2, CS3 and CS4. We write in the specification 4K x 8 for all the 4. Since it's ROM, only read operation is possible. So the OE, which is an active low pin, output enable pin of ROM, will be connected to memory read. in both the case. Whereas in case of RAM, we have both reading and writing. So RD and WR pin of RAM will be connected to MRD and MWR of 8086. Also, the address lines A0 to A11 of both RAM and ROM will be connected to A1 to A12 of the processor address lines, because A0 has been taken as an input to the decoder, so the remaining lines will be connected to these address lines. Now we'll draw the gates to explain how the chip select is obtained. So the ones written to the right are even banks. The one written to the left are odd banks. Let's derive the chip select signals from the truth table we have derived before. We'll do it for odd ROM first. Odd ROM will be these two cases, that is 4100, it's 4, and 110, that is 6. What we do is we'll give 4 and 6 to an AND gate and we'll connect it to chip select 1. Similarly, for chip select 2, which is even ROM is for 100, that's 4, and 1015. So 4 and 5 will be given through an AND gate as input to CS2. CS3 is for odd RAM. Odd RAM is in 000 and 010, that is for 0 and 2. 0 and 2 will be given through an AND gate as input to the CS3 pin. Also for even RAM, 000 and 001, that is 0 and 1 will be fed through an AND gate as input to CS4. This is the final circuit derived. That's all for now. Thank you. Thank you for listening.